Hi, my name is Andrei Osachuk. I welcome you to another training on Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace. Today I want to show you one of the methods that you may want to use for growth rates visualization. The scenario is the following. As an analyst, I want to understand whether last month we performed better than the month before and how to approach this. Usually what we do when we start doing the analysis or preparing a dashboard, we start with a table and probably we'll also need to add a chart. So what I have here, I show the performance of marketing channels for the month of August. And I added the bar visualization so that we will be able to compare the contribution of each channel to the total number. It also helps me to understand which marketing channel contributed the most to that result. And we also can compare those channels among each other, but this is actually it. And how we can understand that we actually perform better or worse? To answer these questions, there are various options, and this depends on the situation. First, we may want to compare the actual result with the target. For example, I could have a target which was 150,000 unique visitors for the month of August. And if I compare the performance against the target, I would understand that I underperformed, I missed my target, and this is not good. Another way how we can compare, how we can interpret the result, we can also compare this with the months before. In other words, we can see whether there is a higher number of unique visitors in comparison to July or lower. And if the number of unique visitors is higher, then the growth rate is positive. Obviously, this is just a framework. You can use any type of KPI and show them in these ways. So now I want to show you another visualization that I prepared for indicating the growth rates to answer the question whether we actually performed well or not. What I have in this table. First, on the left side, I can see total performance for the reporting period, which is August. And underneath, I can see the overall growth rate. Now I can understand that actually in August, we performed worse than in July for this particular KPI, which is currently set to unique visitors. In other words, we were not able to increase traffic on our site. And if our tactic, if our expectation was that this should help us increase traffic on the website, we failed. And this gives me the insight. We failed in our tactics. Our strategy didn't work. We didn't meet our expectations. And afterwards, obviously, I will want to create another deep dive analysis to understand the causes of that. However, since we are currently looking at just visualizations, let's continue. So what I also have here, in the center, I have the same bar chart that helps me to compare different marketing channels. But what I added underneath is the growth rate chart. And these bars help me to quickly recognize which channels showed positive or negative growth. So on the top, I can see the contribution, which channel contributed the most. In this case, this is email marketing. However, very quickly, I can recognize that the email marketing showed a decrease in terms of unique visitors brought to our website. And this is why I highlighted these bars with green and purple color to quickly recognize whether there is a positive or negative growth rate. And as you can see, this is very straightforward in terms of interpretation. And on the right-hand side, I added a table. And in this table, I added the growth rate as another metric. And as you can see, also it's highlighted with red if the growth rate was negative, or with green if the growth rate was positive. Obviously, you need to choose which visualizations you prefer to use in your dashboard or projects, but I just wanted to show you a few examples. But the key idea here, you always can recognize whether you perform better or worse. And this is just an example with months over months growth rate. You may want to use week over week, quarter over quarter, year over year. So for example, you can add another column with year over year grows and to recognize whether you performed in August 2019 better than in August 2018. If you want to learn how to create such visualizations in Analysis Workspace, you're very welcome to enroll in my Adobe Analytics Analysis Workspace Mastery course. The link will be under this video. If you have questions on growth rates, leave them in the comments under this video. This is it for this video. Thank you for watching. Talk to you next time. Bye.